Hey y'all, we just pushed two other ones out today. Now we on to another one. My man Streak from the Soul Brothers. Man, how long you been down with the Soul Brothers, man?
Man, when I started in 95.
Well, in 95, what was they riding back then? I know they weren't on horse and wagons and shit like that, but I'm just saying, what was y'all on back then, man? What was the club running?
When I left and came back, everybody was on FLHTs, but you know me, I was on a fast bike.
Yeah, I heard stories about that yellow bike, man. Who made that bike you had? You still have it.
Yeah, I still got it.
And what was that? Tell us about that bike.
That was Illusion, and it was the first aftermarket Harley that came with their own VIN numbers and they own everything.
Oh, okay.
It was titled as a Illusion.
Okay.
Before Titan came out.
And what kind of motor did that bike have?
S&S everything.
Oh, you want to give the inches of it? You know.
It was 96.
It was 96, but everybody else was on 88 or...
No.
Or was there people on other stuff at the time?
Yeah, they was running 100. They start running them 100 inches down south.
When you came out here in the Bay with your 96, you said,
it wasn't many.
It wasn't many. The competition was pretty much none.
Well, I ran up and down this highway. I ran for the competition.
Okay, you ran for them. Where they at? I'm showing up.
I ran for the competition. Okay.
So does that get what your club name, which was Black Street, does that give that because where you your riding style?
Yeah,
that's how you got that?
Riding style.
As in burn them up out of here, Black Street.
Every time we came through the... In and out the party, it was Black Streaks.
Oh, okay, there you go, Black Street. Yeah. You know, because when I first came on the set, and we was the Fred Nose was the thing for us when I came around, that, man, when y'all entered the party, man, at the Hidden Center, man, people don't know about the Hidden Center back in the Fresno days. Man, y'all come through. It was like all eyes on y'all.
Yeah,
y'all was tearing up shit. Yeah,
yeah
coming in and going out.
Coming in and going out.
Yeah,
when we left the party, the whole party came outside.
Yeah, they were like,
because it was going to be a show.
It was going to be a show, you know, and then you, Nutty, the other people was in there who was good on the throttle hand and clutch hand. Man, it was, man, I'm telling you, as a young cat, man, I was like, man, me too. I want to do that. I want to learn.
We used to go to San Diego. They had this one woman. Sent us a letter down to the clubhouse.
Yeah.
And just on how we performed when we came into San Diego. She used to write us letters over at the clubhouse on Bay Road.
Okay. So, the Soul Brothers, y'all originally from East Palo Alto?
Originally from East Palo Alto.
Oh, okay. Then now y'all branching out. They, you know, I don't know if you're still in the club. I think you retired now, right?
I'm retired now.
I see they've started to push it to other states and stuff, you know, branching out, spreading the wings, you know, as like the Rare Breed, Playhouse, Kings of the South. Everybody's getting people of like minds get together. You know, we're going to come under this one union and, you know, Soul Brothers. On the Soul Brother patch, I've noticed it has two fists. One... was black and the other one was white. What's the significance of that?
It was an interracial club as I came. When I was a kid, I grew up across the street from Heavy.
Mm-hmm. So and Heavy is the founder? You said one of the original guys?
One of the founders.
Okay.
So, you know, from my hair, I didn't hear that as a kid, but as I got older, back then it was interracial clubs didn't exist.
Oh, okay,
and,
okay.
Soul Brothers was one of the, I don't know if it was the first, but they were one of the only ones that was running interracial clubs.
Okay, so.
When I was a young man, I used to see as many Caucasian Soul Brothers come down the street to Heavies as mm-hmm. I did, other race.
Okay, so it was a mixed club, so a lot of clubs weren't having that, but y'all came, come on, we got something in common.
That's right.
And we can all get down together. Mm-hmm. Okay, so I made a statement the other day, guys, which I didn't really elaborate on it, which was basically when you come to my house and you want to do your own, but not telling me you ain't got no music skills. My man was here. How long was you out here messing with this bike, Ron?
Too long.
He said, Rob, I can have it. I'm saying, okay, I'm in here trying to do some other work, so I'm having to oversee it. So I was like doing two jobs at the same time. But... at the end of the day, he didn't have anything turned on. He had a few things mounted. I walked him through it. He had the deck mounted. We walked through how to do the speakers and stuff and like that. He did get dirty. So I applaud that. But at the end of the day, he threw his hands up and said, Rob, I need you to take it to the finish line. So now I'm taking it to the finish line, y'all. We going to take it outside and test tune tomorrow. But we got a little bit. And his current hookup before, when this bike was reincarnated another way, he had just 2 6x9s in the front. And I said, man, if I'm turning this on, let me take it to another level. So when they see you, they're going to want to be you. And, you know, they're going to be like, who did that? And, of course, you know, he'll say, hey, Money's Car Stereo, he did me. But, y'all, man, check out this paint, man, how he got this color flowing here. This is some nice detail. Man, what did your painter call that, Ron, what he did up in there, man?
You know, I'm not really sure.
Because I've seen, like, watermarks, like Rossio does. I've seen other stuff, like, you know, the old metal flakish and stuff. And I believe, are you going to give out the name of your painter who did this for you, or are we going to keep it
Mike
to yourself?
Mike Taylor,
he's a legendary person, you know, and they've been dealing with him for quite a while, and he flows together. Yeah.
When I first seen it, it was a bit too flashy for me. Uh-huh. I'm no spring chicken anymore. So when I first seen it, I started to get rid of it.
Oh, you started to just, I ain't going to be able to do it?
Yeah, it was a bit too loud for me. But after it came together, after it was put together.
Yeah, and you saw how it flowed.
It got a classy look to it.
Okay, yeah, it's not doing too much, not doing too little. It's right there in the middle.
Yeah.
And, you know, it can stand the test time for quite a while.
Yeah.
Because I've had bikes before, y'all, and one of my first bikes when I first came to the scene, it had every known thing to man on it. And then I got to look at my partner, shout out to OG Howard Jordan, and I saw his bike. It was the same wild teal green. And so I ain't gonna lie, I took his balls that my man Horacio did, and I toned it down from here to here. Then we went to the green bike, we toned it down a little bit more. So my new bike is just real simple. So you can't be out there being trendy unless that's just you. You like spending money repeating things over and over again. I want to be able to run this for a while.
Yeah.
What's your next upgrade you looking to do?
I'm gonna build a motor.
Oh, okay. So you're gonna retire it? Y'all, he's still on the 88.
I'm gonna keep that.
And he gave me a run for my 113. I had to run this man down. So it's not always about the motor, it's about the jockey.
That's right.
And I'm gonna tell y'all, that Illusion bike, I saw him drag at least 10 Goodfellas over in Walnut Creek. I pulled over in the car and watched him go by. I was like, God damn. And he hailed him off. I was like, woo, I know that. That motherfucker running. Yeah, so, you know, I'm just letting y'all see what I see. Share with some people I deal with, you know, because I affiliate with my man. We've been here watching snowfall, and he was fighting the feeling, y'all. We've been watching snowfall every day all week long. Watching Franklin Saint get it in. But that's all I got to say about this, y'all. We're going to turn it on tomorrow outside, and we're going to be on to the next one after that. My name's Cross Trail. Just letting y'all see what I see.
What you are to me, you help me reach my destiny. Lying here, counting down before we take our flight of fame.
That's it for tonight, Money's Car Stereo. We gotta go. Until the next episode. Good night. A little test and tune.
Till we take off, baby. Oh, yeah. Gonna touch the sky. Girl, you. Oh,
just what I had to be when I heard you say what you said to me to every dude inside. Look like you're working up an appetite for the night. Check it. By then, I just sat at the back. Keeping you out the way you act. Keep it straight and steady. Getting out of line.
I don't own the rights to the music, but the show is jamming. Let's go back to it.
You're back in your place. Oh, all is well and all is cool. Stay in your place. Don't be no fool. Get along all right. You look like the type that we're trying to fight. There's not been a friend to me. You don't want to offend me. Better play it cool. Don't know what I might do. On breakfast and collard greens, I got what you need. If you want me, 'cause I'm a pimp girl. If you want me, I'm a pimp girl. On breakfast and collard greens, I got what you need.
What you need.
If you want me, I can rock you well. If you want me, I'm gonna do some Jerry.
Today, Sunday, pickup day. Mr. Blackstreet's here to pick up his motorcycle today. And I wanted to show y'all, it's a good item to have. Well, it's kind of don't exist, which is for people who have the older Rogue Live, older FLHTs, you know, take the single din radio. This NEX 3500 was a shit. Yes, it's not waterproof. Okay, I'll say that from the gate. But, you know, if you take proper precautions and you don't let someone wash your bike who doesn't know what they're doing, wet the whole front of your bike up, or you just, they call it a whole bath, you just with a sponge, wipe it down, you know, things will be okay. But what's good about this radio is this. It has Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. So, for example, right now, we're on some Nina Simone. And I know we really can't see it that good, but you got that. But here's the key thing here, guys. Watch this. If you wanted to go somewhere, all you got to say, let me see something here. We'll go to search. There's a microphone right there. Where are we going today, Ron?
Where would you like to go?
I'll see.
I'm going to my shop. I'm headed to 876 Sweeney.
Getting directions to 876 Megan Road, Livermore.
Oh, before you press go, you guys, you got to make sure it hears you correctly. Let's exit out of there. Let's make sure. Oh, the directions you're given is your shop for, what is your shop? What do you do, Ron?
Man, I do car restoration.
Car restoration. We locate up in sunny Redwood City. You know, are you open to the public or what's the deal with that?
I'm done by word of mouth. I got a few projects right now I got going, so I'm kind of booked up.
Uh-huh.
Depending on what people have, I can slide you in and out depending on how much restoration needs you have.
Okay, is there a way they can see your line on work or something like that? Or you have a Facebook page or something of that nature?
I got an Instagram, TTC Restorations and Fabrication.
Uh-huh.
So, yeah, you can find me there. You can see the work that we're doing, the work that's been done, and the work that we're doing now.
Okay. Back to the radio. Mini commercial dropped in there. Let's try that again. Where are we going again? Hold on, let it.
Where would you like to go?
876 Sweeney Avenue, Redwood City.
Getting directions to 876 Sweeney Avenue, Redwood City.
Bam.
Lisa.
You don't want to talk? Don't talk. You want messages?
Head south on Pulgas Avenue, then turn right onto Beach Street.
Bam. There you go. So, you know, it's going to guide you through it. Plus, also, it gives you action for your Pandora, all your other functions on there. And see? Just like that. I don't know if y'all can pick this with the phone. And we got other stuff out there. So anything that's on his phone, on things that work with Apple CarPlay can be added to through his phone, and you can see it on the screen. So, you know, whether he wants to make phone calls, maps, whatever else, music. We'll go back to where Nina was at. And it's going to talk over the navigation we'll get in and tell him where he's going through the music. So I just want to let y'all see what I see. And
back to that. Where did I get to that Pandora?
Okay, so this is the mini school that I bought online. USA Standard here. Presto right there, yep. Pandora. Let's see. Pandora. There you go. There's that Nina right there. So just like that, y'all. If y'all know something about Nina Simone, I didn't know how much of a rebel she was. I saw on the Netflix special about her.
Yeah.
Oh, man, what you got right there, man, in that bag, man?
Oh, this is This is the Big Money Car Stereo.
Okay.
Rap.
There you go. If you're with me, you're with me. I'm everywhere you go, I'll be right there with you.
I might go change into that now. I might end up in Napa somewhere.
You never know. My man likes to do his breakfast runs, man. What do you like about getting out there and going and find different places to eat, man? I see you be encouraging people to come on out there and let's go.
Yeah, I just like to find little hole in the wall spots that, you know, that do good breakfast. I don't like the chains. You know what? I like to find different stuff.
Okay, and then you might meet people along the way and see what's going
on. Meet some people along the way. Well, I always meet people along the way.
Yeah, yeah.
People see you having a good time and just want to cut into you, and you know.
They want to be me too.
They want to be a part of your day, and I'm okay with that.
Okay, y'all see that now? We out of here, Money's Car Stereo. We finna go take some cues from my man here and find us some food today. It's Sunday, a fun day. It's nice in California. We gotta go.